of LuLaRoe Carrie Hofer out of Bismarck, North Dakota. I am a mother of four beautiful kids, and I'm a veteran from the United States Army, where I actually met my husband, who is now serving as a recruiter in the Army. And that is basically why we're here in Bismarck, North Dakota. We are stationed here, and we just moved from California, my home state, out here, and we plan to settle in this wonderful Midwest town and couldn't be more happy that we're here. I started LuLaRoe Carrie Hofer right here in Bismarck. I've been a consultant for 6 months now, and I graduated with a degree in American Studies and minored in Women's Studies from University of Moorhead in Moorhead, Minnesota. And I really, I have no background of fashion. I wear clothes, obviously, and I love looking at people's outfits on Pinterest and at the beach and just out and about, but it is not in my background. But I found, and I hope you will see, that it fits me and it fits my life so well, and it has been a wonderful last 6 months. Again, I have four kids, a dog named Macy here, and I CrossFit, I run, anything outdoors I just love to do, and that's me. Okay, so I'm making this video to hopefully answer any questions that anyone could have about LuLaRoe. What's the hype? You know, what are you seeing out and about? I know you've probably heard about the leggings, but what more is there to LuLaRoe? And then I'm not an expert. I don't know all the answers, but what I do have is my own experience. And I kind of just wanted to share that through the world of YouTube and get it out there. And I think that it's important in a journey to kind of catalog what happens and record what happens through a journal or a photo album. And so this is my way to record my LuLaRoe experience, because I feel like it's going to be very big. And so just after, you know, giving birth, you put the baby book together so you have it and it's fresh in your mind and you remember all those little beautiful details. Well, that's what I'm hoping to do with these videos. There'll be more to come. Subscribe to my YouTube videos right here on this channel, LuLaRoe Carrie Hofer, and we'll just take this journey together. I first found out about LuLaRoe after I had my fourth baby, and he was born in November, and we were having Thanksgiving at my house. So my entire family was coming to kind of celebrate the new baby and to celebrate Thanksgiving. And my birthday actually is just a few months down the road in January. So my sister, who is one of the best gift givers I've, you know, she gives great gifts. She was coming with her family and decided to bring my birthday gift at that time. So because we were all together, she wanted me to open it. And in the bag was LuLaRoe leggings, a Randy tee, a Lindsay cardigan, and an Amelia dress. I know. If anyone has shopped LuLaRoe, that is a bundle of goodness right there. And an Irma as well to go with the leggings. So in my head, you know, just having given birth a few weeks before, I was thinking, okay, Jen, you are a really good gift giver, but what are you thinking giving me clothes? Like, what? I'm not getting dressed. I'm not going anywhere. I literally thought that I had earned to wear yoga pants and sweatpants for the rest of my life. Four kids later, my body was like all over the place, you know, after having kids. You just don't feel like your body is quite yours yet. And I thought, okay, maybe when I get back to my, you know, pre-pregnancy weight, I'll try these on. But she said, just trust me, try them on, and I did. And I really loved the colors. Like, that's what got me right away. She had given me this Irma, and it was a solid, like, dark teal. And it was so rich, and it was just really beautiful. And then the leggings, albeit I've never really worn anything but solid colors on my pants before, I was intrigued because the pattern was just this nice chevron, and it was so pretty. And so I tried them on. They were soft. They were comfortable. And if anyone knows me, you know, once I get home from the day or even just dropping the kids off at school, the first thing I do is change from my clothes and go get into my pajamas so I can just be comfortable as a stay-at-home mom the rest of the day. And I was finding that when I was wearing like the leggings and Irma combo, I would wear it all day long, even being a new mom. So it was just life changing for me. And I lost my train of thought. Where was I going with that statement? What was the question? Oh yeah, so anyway, from her gifts that she got me, I really wanted some more because I was wearing what she got me more than the rest of my clothes because it felt really good. And even after having the baby, and you know, you're kind of jiggly and floppy and things aren't feeling right, you're hormonal, you have this beautiful new bundle that's really taking most of your time and kind of puts you in the back burner. So getting dressed wasn't like, oh yay, let's get dressed in the morning. It was, let me just wear my pajamas because I'm hoping to sleep when he naps. So I wasn't really feeling that with LuLaRoe. I was wearing the clothes, I was comfortable, I felt good, and I actually felt really pretty. And to me, that was just an amazing new experience. And so I became a customer because I knew I needed some more. And luckily, our consultant, my sister's consultant at the time, who is now actually my sponsor, she did an amazing job at styling tips and getting us newbies the information about how to wear the clothes to the best of their ability. And I felt like she did a great job with that. So I felt really comfortable trying new styles and new colors. I mean, basically wore black, gray, white, and navy my entire life. That just was, well, I'm wearing navy right now, but I mean, I can still be me in LuLaRoe, and I think that's really special. But Krista used to do these live sales, and you know, about 6 months after my last baby was born, we got orders to move back to Bismarck, North Dakota from California. So we were taking a full cross-country move with a new baby and three other kids, and I had a lot of time to myself. My husband was long days at the office, working Saturdays most of the time. And it was summertime, so during the day we had a lot of things to do outside. We went to the zoo and everything with the kids. But when I came home, the kids were to sleep and I could really just wind down before my husband got home. So I would make myself dinner and I would pop on a live show. And the way that Krista's page was that it was like a girl's night for me in the comfort of my own home. And so I was thousands of miles away from my sister, my mom, my dad, my whole entire family who was in California. And my sister and my mom are customers. And so we would get on these live sales and we would be messaging like, oh, did you see that top? Oh, that would look so good on you. And then we kind of made these virtual friends. And as sad as that sounds, it was really, really special. And so my husband would come home and he'd be like, are you watching another video? And I wouldn't even need to buy anything. It was nice to have friends that I could spend the evening with, you know, waiting for my significant other to come home and join me. So they really, like LuLaRoe being a customer, you know, the clothes were wonderful. I would wear them every day. I felt like I was branching out of my comfort zone and just getting more and more style because if you knew me before, it was t-shirts and yoga pants. So I really felt excited to get dressed again. And I made a lot of connections when I felt that it could have been a really lonely time for me. So as a customer of LuLaRoe, I just felt this instant change in my life, and it was wonderful. Okay, so LuLaRoe as a business, there was a few things right off the bat. One, they're located, their headquarters are in Corona, California, which, hello, is right where I'm from. So the opportunity to go back to California for trainings or for get-togethers with my family and then put LuLaRoe in the books was really, like, really exciting for me being so far away in North Dakota. Two, it's a family-owned business. And if, I mean, we have four kids, we are love family dinners, we love people coming over, we love hosting parties as a family. Family is everything to John and I. So that's my husband. So the idea that this woman had started her own company and just had her family just totally around her, supporting her, being there in headquarters, showing trainings and things like that. And if you've noticed, if you're really new to LuLaRoe, every item that LuLaRoe carries is named after someone in our founder's life, whether that be her son-in-law, her son, her daughter, her grandkids. Did you know LuLaRoe is actually named after her first three grandkids, Lucy, Lola, and Monroe? So it's so cute, and the fact that she is just family oriented, I just felt safe in that because family is such a big part of my life. And then it's a debt-free company. It's only, I think, 4.5 years old right now, and they are just growing so rapidly but not getting into debt. And if you know me, you know John and I have been on Dave Ramsey. We just became debt-free. We have a budget every month. So that, and even starting this business, I knew I needed to be debt-free right off the bat. And so that really appealed to me too, that a company was following the same kind of goals that we had in our own personal life. The other thing that appealed to me was the idea that clothes, it's so not just about the clothes. And I hope that you'll see that as you follow me in my journey, or if you've already known LuLaRoe, you can feel that too. The clothes are wonderful. They change people and how they feel about themselves, and that is amazing. But the culture of LuLaRoe, I felt like I was on a team. You know, I played sports when I was in high school. I joined the Army, which is a wonderful family, a team to be on. And like CrossFit and things like that, they're really just community oriented. And I felt exactly the same way when I started learning about the LuLaRoe culture. And I appreciated that, and I felt like part of the family. So that is absolutely what appealed to me most about LuLaRoe, the business side. I became a consultant. As a customer, I was, you know, wearing the clothes every single day, and I would be at the bank, at the zoo with the kids, and people would just stop me and say, "Oh my gosh, I love your skirt." And I would say, "Thank you so much." And I would think in my head, I would just hand them my business card. Like, it would be that simple. Or I'd be at the bank and they would say, "Oh my, I love your leggings." And I would just reach into my purse and hand them a business card. And I thought it just fit my life really seamlessly. And I, you know, as a stay-at-home mom of four kids, I thought, how much time do I really have to start my own business and to consistently grow it? That took a lot of time for me to get used to. You know, I'm a stay-at-home mom for 8 years now. I feel like things are running pretty smoothly. You know, you kind of get in a groove with being a stay-at-home mom. And I felt good there. I felt solid. So the idea of branching out to do something for me, like, just for me, you know, we as moms, as wives, we put everyone ahead of ourselves most of the time, and that's okay. That we're good at that. We're really good at that. But sometimes it gets draining because we get lost in that. And I didn't know that. I didn't feel that until, you know, a couple months into LuLaRoe, and boy, was I missing me. And the idea that, you know, I could do something for me, I could bring in some income, I could be creative, you know, learn some new things, because I love to get my brain on fire and learn new things. And I thought, well, I don't know how to ship. I don't even know how to set up a Facebook group. I've never, you know, sold clothes before. This would be a huge challenge for me, and I love challenges. So I thought, you know, I wonder what the business opportunity is. And, you know, with me, most of the time when I find something that I know that like the universe is telling me I need to get involved, you know, CrossFit, the Army, marrying my husband, having our fourth kid, you know, it just, one day you're just, yep, that's how I work. It hits me and I just know I need to move forward on it. And I was literally like losing sleep. So I would be up in the apartment, you know, I'd be dead tired because I had the kids all day and long days, but nurse the baby, and then I couldn't fall back asleep because I was constantly thinking about LuLaRoe and the opportunity. And so I would go into the bathroom because, you know, you had to keep quiet with the baby sleeping. And I would just be on my phone watching YouTube videos of different consultants and their experiences. And I was really excited. I thought, I think I can do this. I think this would be really fun and really challenging and just be really different. And I already knew I loved the clothes, so hey, a discount on that, and I have kids and a husband to dress, excellent. But the main thing for me, we are on a one income kind of family. My husband's on a military paycheck. I hadn't been bringing in any money for 8 years, and in our lives, I think with social media, we come across a lot of things that move us, you know, stories of people having hard times or organizations that are asking for help in any way. And my husband and I are really good at giving. We feel like we can give our time and gifts and things like that, and the little talents that we have, we try to give those. But financially, it just was not in the books for us. Always, always, always a dream of mine, if I was to become a millionaire or a billionaire, that I would have that money to give it away. Something about giving money is just really something I've always thought that would be super cool to do. And so I have this list in my journal, and if anything moved me, if any families that were going through hard times, I would write their names, and it's titled, When I Become a Millionaire, These Will Get My Money. And you know, with Dave Ramsey too, they talk about giving and 10% of your paycheck, and it just wasn't feasible for us. But I thought LuLaRoe could give me that opportunity. So we keep LuLaRoe very separate from our personal finances. And that allows me to give 10% to a charity or to a family every single month. And I think that is absolutely why. That's my why in LuLaRoe. That's what drives me to get up in the morning and have some late nights and to be the kind of customer service representative that I would appreciate. And just going that extra mile and you know, so that I can give on behalf of all of my members 10% of my paycheck. And I'm hoping, like in my head, that number is going to be big every single month. And so when I think the next question is that, right? What is my why?
What is your LuLaRoe why?
So yeah, so my LuLaRoe why is to give 10% financially to charities or to people every single month. And when I, my first month, you know, it was $586 that I was able to give at the end of the month. And I called my family down. I got the, you know, GoFundMe page up, and we pressed that button and we cheered because it was important for John and I to show our kids that giving is so important. It's just, it needs to be part of an everyday life for you. And at our dinner table, we say what we're thankful for the day and what we gave. And even if it's a smile or you open the door for somebody or you gave part of your lunch away, which was one of my son's things from kindergarten, which is great. It's good giving, but we still need to eat our food. So we're tweaking that. We're making that more understandable for little kids' minds. But for John and I to show our kids that we are constantly and consistently giving financially was super, super important to us. And we get to do that every single month. I have a tally on my Facebook group that shows exactly how much we have given so far, and I cannot wait to see that number just grow and grow. Because when I can send a big fatty check that makes me feel like I'm doing my part in the world. And I worked hard, and people worked hard to do that. And we have a mission, and that's it. And it just, it's really exciting to see and to feel and to know that that number is going to get really big, and we're going to make real big differences in people's lives, even more so than feeling amazing and beautiful in our clothes. So that is absolutely my why. And honestly, there's been so many things since day one that I didn't even know it. The why, they say, kind of changes and everything like that. And I agree. Why I do the things that I do in this business is grow, like every day it seems like something new comes up. You know, someone, I think Sherry was going to remind me about this story, and this was one of my first experiences with how this is so much more about clothes. You know, this business is so much more, and this example kind of proves that. It was, you know, I got this Randy tee in one of my boxes, and I opened it up and I thought, it wasn't ugly at all, but it just was one of those patterns that I thought, this is going to sit in my boutique for a long time because it's going to take a very special customer to want this shirt. And it was this, you know, kind of a cream colored, and had these blue fish. And they were big fish swimming around the middle of the shirt. And they weren't like cute cartoon fish or anything like that. They were like literally, I think they were salmon or trout or something like that. And it looked like something from a biology or a nature book, you know, a National Geographic magazine, where they kind of, you know, really display what the fish look like. And so it was real life, and I thought, okay, we'll just be looking at this here for a while. Well, I put it on my sale and online, which I have every Monday, and one of my members, you know, said, can you please add this friend of mine? She has been searching for that Randy. And I thought, what? Sure. So I added her, and she messaged me, and she says, I am so excited. I finally found this Randy tee. And I thought, Are you a fisherman? Like, what's the appeal on this shirt that you've been searching for so long? So it was kind of like black leggings. And I thought, these are no black leggings. But after getting to know her, she was a military wife as well. Her husband was deployed 9 months, and she had a little one at home. You know, she was searching for this shirt because her dad had had a stroke just a few weeks before, and she was making the trek to go visit him in the hospital. And she was leaving the next weekend. And so this was like last minute find. She was so excited. And we shipped it to her right away, and she got it. And you know, my members voted to give it to her for free. So we shipped it to her for free. We got her there, and she took a picture with her dad. And the reason why it was so important to her to have this when she visited her dad, who had had a stroke, is because, as many as you know, when you have a stroke, you lose some of your recollections, your memories. And so she wanted to bring something that was very special to her memory of her dad, and that was going fishing with him all growing up. So she sent a picture of me with her dad, and she's wearing the Randy. And you know, at that moment, I knew this is what it's all about. This is, okay, it's not just a fish shirt that I might not think is a very attractive. This is about how you feel in your clothes and what types of emotions. It's like, it's wearable happiness to me, and proven by so many different instances. And I share those on my page all the time because they are constantly moving me and just stopping me in my tracks. And this is so unique that something like that could happen from something that I had in my shop. And I was just really grateful. So she's a wonderful customer now, and she's got her whole family on board, and her dad is doing okay. But that was a really special turning point for our business, and to know that we could really be changing lives, and, you know, just by a single piece of clothing. So that are some of my whys, my biggest whys for being a LuLaRoe consultant. That I can do it with four kids, being a stay-at-home mom in the middle of Bismarck, North Dakota. I can run a successful business, and I never thought that could be possible. I've learned that people really need to feel good daily, and that these clothes make that possible. You know, it brightens people's days, it makes them confident. If you have a road trip coming up and you need cars on your legs to have fun for a 9-hour day of driving, hey, we've got that for you. So I've learned to have a lot of fun with clothes, and it really makes a difference in our daily lives, how we feel as moms, as kids, as men, to feel comfortable and confident in what we wear and how we, you know, I think if you feel like you look beautiful, you're going to be better at everything that you do. You're going to be a better mom. You're going to be a better wife. You're going to be a better teacher. You're just going to be able to feel good. And that makes a big difference day to day to day to day. And that just accumulates. It snowballs. And so these 6 months, holy moly, I feel like I'm on cloud nine. I feel like, you know, we were looking, I knew that once my kids were in school, I would go back to, you know, working, you know, at least part-time. And because my job would kind of be done while the kids were in school. And so during that time, maybe, you know, finally start adding to the monthly budget and just helping out and actually wanting to get back into the workplace because, hello, I could talk to adults. That would be amazing. So I've learned that I can do that. Literally, my commute is 8 steps down. I have my boutique in my home. I'm not, you know, taking my inventory to the pop-ups, what is what a lot of consultants can do. I'm lucky enough that I have the space in my home to invite people to my house and for them to shop in a comfortable home environment. And I don't even have to go to the post office. UPS comes to my door. And so I've learned that you can run this business however you want to. I have an online customer base, which is so wonderful to you know, do those early sales, do those late sales where I can still be a mom during the day. And like right now, okay, it's in the middle of the day. I have a videographer like right there doing her awesomeness. I have a microphone, like this is totally professional, and I'm not a professional yet. So it's really just exciting to know that I'm doing it and I can be as creative as I want, and the clothes sell themselves, and I am just running with it, running with this company that is growing and that has this wonderful culture, and I couldn't be more thrilled that I found that LuLaRoe was literally given to me and that we ran with it as a family. I've learned that, you know, I can have friends over, they can shop right in the middle of the day, and it doesn't disrupt me as a mom, and my number one job is being a stay-at-home mom, and that is really exciting to me. So I've learned a ton. I've learned how to ship from my home. Never thought I would need to know how to do that, but I've learned how to, you know, accessorize and to, you know, wear things differently to different body types. I love to research fashion now, and I hope that you can see that in my page, that we go all out. We have a lot of fun, and we're going to make you feel really beautiful and confident. Even if you were before, it's just going to add to that, and you're going to rock LuLaRoe. And hey, if you want to start your own business, we're going to make sure that you know how to do that so you can rock it in your own life like I feel I have right now. Okay, so my typical day, I remember as a, you know, customer looking into what the opportunity, the business side of it was going to be like, and I was like, I need to know facts. Like, I'm a stay-at-home mom. I want to know what other stay-at-home moms do and how they run their businesses. So I'll just pick today. Today, I woke up at, you know, 6 a.m., and I got my quick workout in, and I shipped and I bagged for porch pickup a few items. I went on my computer and I just messaged people who had questions about different items. And then at 7 o'clock, I wake up all the kids My husband was already gone at work, so it was just me this morning. We got breakfast and we got dressed and teeth brushed, and we were at 8 o'clock on our way to school. So dropped everybody off at school, came back, you know, played with the little. I have two at home right now. We played, we did puzzles, you know, it's typical stay-at-home mom stuff. Don't do that. Yes, let's do that. Laughing a lot because they're hilarious at this age. And I didn't even get ready. So Sherry came over. We had an appointment for this video at 11 o'clock. And I was able from 11 to noon to put the kids to sleep and get myself ready for this video. And here we are. So after this, it's back to being a mom until the kids come home at 4. And then I think we're going grocery shopping for our weekly. I mean, this is really exciting stuff, y'all. Grocery shopping, and then we're doing Friday night homework. I know, I'm a stickler. Just get it done right away. Teaching those good habits that I did not have as in high school. So I want to make sure they have that. And then we're just going to have a family night. And then tonight, after the kids go to bed, I hop on live and I do my February recap. I do that at the end of the month so everybody knows where I'm at and where the next month is headed. And that is my day. It's amazing. It's a lot of room for working and being a mom, and it's a lot of fun. Oh, and then at 7, Brian, my UPS guy, is delivering 2 new boxes of inventory because on Saturday, people are coming here to shop. So, I mean, this was a good day today. And that's what my typical days look like depending on if I have a sale or not. So, yeah, that's what's happening over at the Hofer House. Well, I have no idea. I am literally just flying by the seat of my pants. I kind of do that. And I have goals. I have, you know, I have my calendar. I have my monthly goals. But honestly, these last 6 months have taken me by huge surprise. We paid off our initial inventory right away. We paid cash to start. So it wasn't like we were paying off a credit card or anything, which some consultants do. But we've made our investment back, and so that was the big thing when we started. Like, as long as you make your investment back and you're having fun, let's do it. And I feel like it's just gone from that to major beyond that. We are still going to be giving 10% of our profits to a charity of the month, and I'm really hoping to up that. You know, as my inventory grows and I'm putting money back and investing in my business, as soon as we hit that plateau and I get to the count that I need to, or I get to the team that I would like to kind of stay settled at that works for me and my family, I feel like upping that percentage is going to be really exciting. And literally, I want to make money to give it away. That is my why, and that is what my goals are. Obviously, with growing and doing these YouTube videos, I hope to grow my team. I'm ready to be a leader. I do have a team under me right now. My mom and my sister are a partner team. They don't do that anymore, but they were one of the last ones to get in there. And they are rocking it over in California. And then they have someone underneath them. So it's just growing really organically and really great. And, you know, I don't know where it's going to take me, but I know I want to get on that cruise, and I think that I will get there. I will be able to take my husband on a 10-day Caribbean cruise because I earned it in LuLaRoe. And what? That's like, we've never been on a cruise before. We have 4 kids. We aren't going. No, that is absolutely possible, and I know that I will be there sometime soon. So the next 6 months, the next 6 years, the next 60 years, I have no idea. But what I can tell you is that you can follow me right here on this channel, and I'll tell you everything you want to know. As you know, I like to talk. I'm detailed. I'm an open book, and I love to talk about money and finance and those small attentions to detail that really will either help your decision making or just get you really excited to think about the possibilities. So I hope that these videos will really help you. If you're one like me and it's 2 o'clock in the morning and everyone's sleeping in your family and you're on YouTube trying to figure out if LuLaRoe is the right move for you, well, all I can say is I don't know, but I will sure help you find that out. You can always contact me at LuLaRoeCarrieHofer@gmail.com, and all of these links will be posted right below in the little description there. My Facebook group is LuLaRoe Carrie Hofer. This channel, of course, on YouTube, and then I'm on Instagram at LuLaRoe by Carrie Hofer. I hope you follow along. I hope that, I'm not the smartest, I'm not the sharpest knife in the box, anything like that, but I do know what my own experiences are, and I'm hoping and just excited to know that they might help you and get you to where you would like to be, and just open up not Pandora's box, but the UPS box of just all these possibilities. You have a dream, LuLaRoe can certainly get you there, and let's just see if that's gonna work for you. So hopefully you follow along. I would love to see you again. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time. Bye, guys.